Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to change these texts like billing details, your order, or even additional information to something like personal details, order details, and then we shall be able to change this into order information. And we're going to do this through a plugin. So if this is something you're interested in, let's start the video right now. If you're new to this channel, we always do WordPress and WooCommerce stuff, so feel free to subscribe. Like the video if you enjoy it or if it gives you value, and leave a comment if you have any other questions. Otherwise, let's jump into the video. So I'm going to open up my editor here, and I'll go into my root folder of my website. I'll go into WP Content, and I'm going to look inside the plugins folder, and what I'm going to do is drag and drop WooCommerce to my editor. If we search WooCommerce for billing details, you'll see that we have it in a number of classes, like the class of WC Admin List Table Orders and form-billing.php. If you look at this, it's just a translated string, and it doesn't have anything like apply filters to it, which would give us a particular filter for us to be able to tap in and just change this. So we go to WordPress, and you'll find that there's this filter called Get Text, and we're going to use Get Text to get that particular text and then change what we have here on our front end. So I'll go back to my editor. I'm also going to go back into my plugins. I'll create a new folder, which I'm going to call Change Woo Texts. I'll drag and drop this into my editor. I'll then create a new file, which I'll call change-woo-texts.php. And then inside here, I'm going to open up with PHP. I'll use my start plugin snippet to help me go ahead into starting my plugin. I'll call this change woo texts, and then I'll change the author plugin link. So I'll give it my blog page, and then I'll give it my name, so TechiePress, and then I'll just say this plugin changes the texts on the checkout page. So just change this to on. It will be a version 1. I'll give it a license of GPL2 or later. And then I'll just give this a change woo texts. So the next thing we're going to do, of course, is we shall do a simple apps path check to see that someone is not logging from outside the plugin, but we're logging from inside. So if we find that someone is trying to cheat, we'll say you are cheating. And then that will allow us to have a basic plugin. So I'm going to save this. I'll go back into my editor. I'll go back to my browser. I'll go into the WP admin. I'll log in on the front end. And after logging into my dashboard, I'm going to go to plugins. And then I'll activate my change woo text right here. So I'm just going to go back to my store. And then I'll go to the checkout. And then what we're going to do is now start working on our particular plugin to make the changes. So I'll add filter. I want to use the get text tag. And after doing that, I'm going to add my own function, which I'll call TechiePress change woo underscore text. And I need to wrap this inside single quotes. And what I want to do is just give this a priority of, let's say, 100, so that it comes a little later. And I'm going to pass in 3 arguments in this particular function. So I'll remove this, and then we shall be able to get a new function, which I'm going to copy here. It's a function, add that, and then I'll open up my function. And we need to pass the 3 arguments down inside this place. We're going to get the first thing we shall get is the translated string. And then we are also going to get the text dash string. And finally, we are going to also get the text domain. And this all corresponds to these apply filters that we had here. So we have the translation, the text string that we need, and the text domain as well. So what I'm going to do is come back in here, and I would say we're going to do a return. And what we actually want to return is this translated string. So I'll copy this, paste it here. The first thing I'm going to do is var dump all the strings that we have so that we can be able to see what's actually going on. So I'm going to copy this, put it in here and save this. Let's go back to the front end of our checkout and reload it. And you'll see that we have a number of strings like WooCommerce, WooCommerce data, WooCommerce orders, and all these things. So if I quickly look, you'll see that we have billing details right here, and you'll see that we have your order also available. So we shall be able to tap all these particular items and loop them through a switch statement. I'm going to use a switch statement and say every time we loop through the translated string, we should be able to find the string that is called billing details. So inside here, I'm going to say case, and the case we are looking for is billing details. And we'll say every time we have that, we'll say that our translated string is going to actually equal to something that will allow for translation to happen. And we're going to pass in something and say these are going to be personal details. We'll add a comma and add our text domain. After adding our text domain, we're going to add the break and we shall close this. We're just going to make sure that this is the word that we have and it's exactly as we see it on the screen. So I'll come back here and check, and we'll see that this D is actually lowercase. So I'll change this into lowercase, save this. Then we're going to come back and reload this page. And you'll see that it now changes to personal details. So we're going to get the your order. Now we are also going to get this additional information here. I'll come back in here and we're going to make a number of cases. So I'm going to duplicate this 3 times and we'll look for when we have your order. And we're going to say order details for that case. And we're going to change this to additional information and we shall say order info. So order info. I'll save this. I'm going to come back to our browser. I'll reload. And you'll see that here it's personal details. We have order details. And then we also have the order info right here. Now, if the switch statement is something that is new to you, this is just basically a loop that's going through. We can actually just even use if statements and say if the translated string is actually equal to the billing details. So I'll cut this. I'll add 3 equal signs to say it should be a text string and it's having that information. We shall remove this case and say the string is going to be equal to that. So I'll close that. I'm going to copy this so that we have the same thing over, and we're going to change that this time it should be equal to your order. We'll add this closing bracket, open a quotation here. I'll change all of this as well and put, of course, the closing bracket right there. I'll paste this again so that we just have this additional information coming in the place of this billing details. I'll just make some space here so that our code is better readable. I'll remove this break because we don't need it. And then I'm going to just stub this in a little bit. You'll see that we're checking if the string is billing details, we make it personal. If we have your order, we make it order details. If it's additional information, we make it order info. So let me add order information and change this to order info. And then I'll say personal info so that we can see that there's a difference. I'll come back here, I'll reload, and you'll see that we have it as we wanted, personal info, order info, and then we have also the order information. So if this is going to help you out in your WooCommerce, I hope that you've liked the video. Give it a thumbs up if you've enjoyed it. Don't forget to subscribe if you're new, and leave me a question or an answer in the comment section. Otherwise, enjoy what you're building.